So the key to the first ride here now, because I know she wants to buck, is just make it pretty enjoyable, right? So it's going to be pretty benign, hopefully. I'll just get on her, let her walk around a little bit if she will. I'm not going to pressure her up. I'm not going to make her run. I'm just going to let her figure out that it's okay to have me up there. And quite often, it's probably preferable to have me on the ground here where she's really having to work her tail off. So I'll get on her like I get on any colt. I'll make sure she's comfortable. I want to see if I got any kind of control of that back end. So I'm going to bring her nose around to my boot here, this lateral flex. Right rein is loose, left rein is tight enough that she can't take her nose back. So her answer to this is going to be to move her hind quarter to line up with her nose to relieve the pressure on her neck. And when she does that, I'll release that rein as a reward. Okay? But it's instilling this, what we call disengaging the hind quarter, where I can pick up that left rein and have her move her hip around her forehand, which is kind of like an emergency brake, right? It'll help her stop. So I'll kind of encourage her to move out a little bit. I just want her to step that hind quarter like that. Perfect. And then I give her head. And I've released that pressure. That was really good. We'll do that the other way. I get on and off my colts, both sides. I'm not as flexible or as coordinated on this side, but I still do it because it's something new to them for the most part. Right? They don't feel that very often. And then if you don't ever do that and you get on and the first time you turn right and the first time they see you out of that eye up top there, that's when they get concerned. Again, I want to make it easy on her, but I want to have control. So I'm just going to keep her nose, ask her to step out. She's going to move her hind end to my right, her right. And if she does, I release the pressure. So I'm just reinforcing that I can control that hind quarter. So if she gets scared, that's all I got to do. They can't buck or bolt or rear or run away if I can disengage their hind quarter. She does it relaxed, kind of head down like that. Nice. I'm just going to let her walk out. She's starting to get a little bit antsy there with me up here. So I'm just going to take a little shorter rein, a little more control of that hind quarter. And if she got real scared, I'm going to take all of that hind quarter like that. Okay? And stop her. But I want her to know that this is okay. I'll let her walk out a little bit. She's got such kind of a nice natural low headset, it's hard to tell if she's trying to just find her happy place or if she wants to get her nose between her feet so she can drop her head and buck me off. But we'll find out. I'm just going to let her go. Bring my second rein in there just to see what she knows. Yeah, nice collection there already. Naturally talented mare for sure, and some really nice groundwork has been done with this horse. Ooh. All right, Derek, look at that. I'm gonna say that this horse has probably been ground drove a little bit, maybe. Because she really understands that bit and she knows to kind of back off it and where to find that release, right? Like, see how light that is for the first ride. Yeah, they've done some nice work with her, which is going to give me the confidence that if she did get really stupid on me and wanted to take off her buck, I'd probably be able to get her stopped. And that's going to be the key with her, is just get her rode a few times when she has those little episodes and make it kind of uncomfortable when she does it. And make this right here real comfortable.
Ooh,
look at that. Oh, she's talented, man. Really nice, man. Hey, girl. Yeah, I don't. She's not bucking because she's mean at all. It's just been kind of the answer, right? She gets spooked at something or something's bothering her. That's what's worked, so that's her go-to. But we'll fix that. I'll bring her around to the right, and this is where sometimes this transition is where it gets real, a little bit snorty. But you know, she's seen me up here on the right eye, so she shouldn't be too bad. But it's quite often it's that right there. You can see her. Kind of get a little excited, right? So I'll bring her back around to the left where I got more control. And she wants to go a little bit. And you see, I just picked up on that rein, redirected that energy, and took away that hindquarter. So I'll kind of let her go a little bit if she wants to. Potential to be a really nice hackmore and bridle horse the way she wants to carry herself. But and I'm going to bring her back around to the right one time and then we'll quit her. So I haven't worked this side as much to disengage the hindquarters, so I won't have quite as much control. So I'm keeping my left rein just in a position that if I need to get a hold of her, I'll probably go back to my left. But we'll let her take a few steps this way. There we go. Good girl. There we go. I'll let her walk out this way. Stop her, back her off a bit, just to instill that collection and give him a bit. Really nice. So I get off colt just like I get on him. I let him know I'm coming. And for those that are concerned about the sweat, it's like 30 degrees out here today or whatever that is, Fahrenheit, 95 or something. Ridiculous. So it's warm.